I know there's things you cannot tell me. But I also know there's a story here, and I think everybody will hear about it.
Do you think your paper has the resources to take that on?
I do. Do you?
The Boston priests molested kids in 6 different parishes over the last 30 years. The church found out about it and did nothing.
We haven't committed any long-term investigative resources to the case.
No, we haven't.
And that's the kind of thing your team would do.
Spotlight.
Guys, listen. Everybody's going to be interested in this.
I've watched a few of your interviews about the movie, and like a few times you say it's an important film. What do you want people to take away from it after
well,
this?
Well, yeah, and you know, I hear that said back to me and it makes me cringe a little bit, to be honest. But I think that because of the subject matter, because of the work that these journalists did, was so important. I mean, it was work that, you know, impacted the fabric of our society on a global level, right? It started in Boston and had national, international repercussions. It was such an important story to not everyone, specifically, obviously, even to the Catholic Church, right? So I think that's where the import comes from. And as a writer and as a storyteller, as a filmmaker, you feel that. And you're like, oh, man, I want to get this right. I want to do justice to this. Because as we've seen in our country now with the release of the movie, it's giving the story a second life. People are revisiting this and understanding this. And I think in some ways could cope with the story now that there's a little bit of distance. Mm-hmm. Not to say this problem isn't still going on. It is, but there's a little bit of distance, and seeing it through the reporter's eyes, through the investigation, it almost makes it a little bit more palatable for audiences, so they can really engage in the subject matter, in the crisis, and I think that response from people has been incredibly gratifying.
We understand you've settled several cases against the church.
I can't discuss that.
There aren't any records of any of these settlements.
Nope.
When you're a poor kid from a poor family, and when a priest pays attention to you, it's a big deal.
Getting these initial actors involved, Mark Ruffalo, Michael Keaton, Rachel McAdams, Stanley Tucci, Liev Schreiber, that really came together pretty quickly. I reached out to these guys, in many cases individually, that I had a new project and had a script and wanted them to read, and heard back pretty quickly. So we were really lucky. Some of them I didn't know, like Rachel, I had never worked with, I didn't know her. I knew of her work, but I hadn't seen her do anything like this. So we had a couple of discussions and decided it was right, and we were very fortunate to get her.
Don't try to silence anyone who speaks out.
You leave me alone, you hear me, goddammit?
6% act out sexually.
6% is 90.
90 priests.
If there were 90 of these bastards, people would know.
Maybe they do.
Yeah, like the story is very much linked with Ireland. Obviously, Boston is a huge Irish town. A lot of these people, the survivors are Irish Catholics. There's
right.
The priests of Irish names.
Right.
At the end credits, you see Irish towns named.
Right.
Are you particularly interested to see what the response is in Ireland?
Yeah, very. I mean, I feel very, obviously, as a McCarthy, I feel very connected to Ireland. I've spent a lot of time here over the years. And with this particular subject matter, I'm very excited to be here with the film. And look, I think Ireland's reaction to the crisis and to the Catholic Church is nothing short of historic. I think it's very different than maybe the other great Catholic country in Europe, which is Italy, and their relationship to the church. We premiered the movie at the Venice Film Festival. So I'm really excited to just to see what the discussion is and how people approach this movie and what they take away from it.
Hmm. What is your Irish ancestry? Where are you from?
We know we're from somewhere down around Cork. We trace records back to there and then lost it. So from my father, who spent a lot of time here, I was just saying this last interview, but he made it. They said there were records in a church that burned to the ground, was what he was told. And then he got... was sad and went home. So one day we got to figure it out.
We've got two stories here. A story about degenerate clergy and a story about a bunch of lawyers turning child abuse into a cottage industry. Which story do you want us to write? Because we're writing one of them.
The Oscar nominations?
Exciting.
Yeah.
Look, it's all about raising awareness of the movie and getting people to see it. But, you know, the Oscars specifically voted on by my colleagues and peers to have 6 nominations for a movie like this in today's market is really exciting. We're thrilled.
Do you enjoy those nights?
By and large, not as much as everyone thinks you would. They could be, they're not always the most natural and comfortable of places. But along the way, you get to meet a lot of wonderful people. You get to meet a lot of people that you haven't had the chance to or revisit friends. And that's exciting. You know, I was saying earlier, I keep running into all these wonderful Irish directors that are nominated this year for a bunch of different things. Lenny and John. And It's great. I've never met those guys. Both great guys. So when you have that opportunity, it's pretty cool. But you know, all the dinners and the talking, it can get a bit old.
They knew, and they let it happen. It could have been you. It could have been me. It could have been any of us.